Topaz Labs released Starlight Mini in May 2025. Unlike the cloud-based Project Starlight, Mini runs locally inside Topaz Video AI, so that means you can run it as much as you want and you don't need to pay for credits. I reviewed Project Starlight in February 2025. In this video, I'm taking another look at Starlight, comparing the settings called Speed and Quality, and I'm also comparing it to Starlight Mini, which runs inside Topaz Video AI. Apart from the visual comparison, I'll also compare the rendering time and the cost. By the way, watch the end to see the joke at the end of the video. All right, I have six comparisons to show you. Start with test number one. On the left is the original capture that I merely deinterlaced with a QTGMC. And in the middle, we've got the output from Starlight from February 2025. And on the right is Starlight Mini from June 2025. The most noticeable thing is that Starlight Mini is darker than Starlight, and that's something I noticed across all of the Mini clips. And I think this is related to the second thing you may notice, which is that Starlight Mini has what the Topaz website calls a subtle haze. Lines and wrinkles on faces aren't as harsh, it's a more natural look, and as they explain, this greatly reduces the plastic look of upscales and enhancements that are too clean. Now, looking at this still image, you can see that Starlight Mini does a much better job than the February version of Starlight. The overly sharp edges on the face are gone. And also notice that the horizontal pattern in the jacket is more accurate in Starlight Mini than it was in the February Starlight. But this is the test I really wanted to see. This is the updated version of Project Starlight versus Starlight Mini. The new Starlight is in the middle, and it has improved. Now, you may want to watch this again yourself, but in looking at the still image, you can tell that the jacket has the correct horizontal pattern. The face is more natural than before in the February Starlight, but it doesn't quite have that pleasant haze like on Starlight Mini. The updated Project Starlight now has two quality settings. They call them Speed and Quality. Now, here's a comparison of those two settings. And to be honest, I can't really see a difference in this test, this VHS test. But as always, if you see something I've missed, then leave a comment. Now, the quality setting is three times as expensive as the speed setting, so it would be awesome if the speed setting was pretty much identical to the quality setting. But as we'll see later in other tests, you do notice a difference. All right, here's another comparison of the June Project Starlight versus the June Starlight Mini. And I've adjusted the brightness of Mini to make it closer to the other one. Now, you can really see the benefit of that haze layer on Mini. The VHS footage looks more natural with Mini. So, my conclusion about test number one is that the cloud-based Starlight has improved, but Starlight Mini produces a softer image that, in my opinion, is much better for standard definition and especially VHS quality footage. Of course, processing your videos with Starlight Mini takes a long time, and we will quantify that after these comparison videos. For test number two, we have some DV25 footage from a MiniDV camcorder, and here's a comparison of the February 2025 Starlight versus the June Starlight with the quality setting. And you can see they look pretty similar. Now, in this comparison, you can see a difference between Starlight speed setting and Starlight quality setting. Quality produces a softer image. Look at the blue card in the background. You can tell that it's more vibrant in the speed setting, and the face is more red in the speed setting. It's as if the Starlight quality setting has reduced saturation to make things look more natural. And now let's compare all three of them, Starlight speed, Starlight quality, and Starlight Mini. I always check the teeth. I find it's a really good indicator of whether the model is overdoing it. And you can see that Starlight Speed is creating these Frankenstein-style teeth that look really weird. Quality has some kind of haze, it seems, that's creating a softer image. And so is Starlight Mini. I think Starlight Mini is even softer. Now, in this version, I've brightened Starlight Mini so we can have a better comparison. Okay, so what can we conclude here from test number two? Well, first, I think that the February Starlight is closest to the June Starlight with the quality setting active. Second, I think that the quality setting produces a softer image than the speed setting. And third, I think that Starlight Mini is even softer than Starlight, even with that quality setting. And of course, Starlight passes that teeth test. So for this type of mini DV footage, I think it's more or less a tie between Starlight with the quality setting and Starlight Mini. Okay, so we've tested the VHS footage and the mini DV footage, and now let's test the MJPEG footage from a Canon Powershot SD110 camera, circa 2004. This was the beginning of using little digital cameras to record video. The resolution was only 640 by 480, and it only records at 15 frames a second. Now, the Starlight from February 2025 is doing really weird things to the faces of the people on the street. So let's get rid of that one. Let's do the proper test. Here is the June Starlight in the middle. It's got the speed setting. And this actually looks way worse. I think that the problem is that it is a 15 frames per second video, and the speed setting is somehow botching that up. All right, let's get rid of that. Let's run it again, this time with the Starlight quality setting in the middle. And as you can see, that's better. But Starlight Mini is outperforming it. Mini does a better job at people's faces and moving objects. Now, Mini does add those sort of alien-looking letters on the store signs. But other than that, it really does very well with this footage. Okay, let's move on to test number four. We have some more DV25 footage, and we're going to skip that February Starlight footage and cut to the chase. There's the quality footage in the middle, Mini on the right. Let's adjust the contrast and brightness of Mini so we can really compare these. And it's sort of hard to tell with footage like this, but I guess I always prefer Starlight when it doesn't try to overdo the faces. So in that sense, I like that Starlight Mini is keeping it natural. Okay, test number five is another MJPEG video, but this time it's from the Canon Powershot SD1000. It's got a resolution of 640 by 480, but Canon gave us 30 frames per second in this camera. And here are both versions of Starlight, and it's pretty close. If you compare them more closely, I find that the cloud-based Starlight with quality setting is overdoing those faces. I know I keep repeating this, but Mini is adding that haze or whatever, and the results look more natural for this type of footage. And by the way, this is the St. Alfio's Band of Lawrence, Massachusetts from July 2007. I mention this so that the closed captions can transcribe it, and perhaps the folks there can find this video. Anyway, here's the Starlight speed version versus the Starlight quality version versus the Starlight Mini version. So for test number five, I think that the 30 frames per second avoids the problem we saw with Starlight speed in the earlier video that was 15 frames per second. So I think that was probably the issue, and it doesn't struggle in the same way. But you can really see that the image gets softer as we move from the Starlight speed to Starlight quality to Starlight Mini. Okay, for test number six, we have some mini DV footage. This is the footage from a previous video. This was the footage from Hyannis of some typical Cape Cod houses. And then we have that slow zoom into the Kennedy compound. And let's look at the still image of the home. In my previous video, I was astounded by how amazing that Starlight from February was in creating details. I know some people said the details weren't there, but I mean, come on, this is unreal. Now, Mini has done this too in this video. And like everything else, it's softer and I think more natural. All right, let's compare speed, quality, and Mini. Okay, let's pause right there. Okay, well, the speed and the quality look the same to me. I can't really tell a difference. But Mini is softer, looks more natural. And even look at that flag. In Mini, the flag seems to be more accurate. For whatever reason, Mini is doing a better job on that particular detail. So our conclusion for test number 6, I think that speed and quality in Starlight look the same, but Starlight Mini is softer, it wins the flag test, and that, again, is my preference. Okay, so what can we conclude after these 6 tests? I think that Starlight Mini looks better than the cloud-based Starlight, both the Starlight with the speed setting and the Starlight with quality setting. And whether it's because of the haze or the reduced saturation, Starlight Mini is softening the details on the objects and the faces, and I think the result is more natural. And I think it's ideal for standard definition footage, especially VHS footage. But even MiniDV footage and those early digital cameras, I think it looks better on those as well. My only issue with Starlight Mini is that it's darker than the others, so you'll need to adjust that in Premiere or Resolve or whatever you use if you want to try to bring up the brightness. All right, let's compare the costs of the cloud-based, credit-based Starlight with Starlight Mini. So for the cloud-based software, you need to buy credits, and you can choose between an upscale of 1080 or a 4K. And you can also choose between speed setting and quality setting. Now, this is how much it costs for a minute of video at HD quality. And this is how much it costs per hour of video. So at these prices, it seems like the obvious choice is to buy Topaz Video AI desktop software for $299 US and just use Starlight Mini in there. And if you want to continue getting upgrades every year, it's going to be another $199. But still, it's a much better deal if you have a lot of video to process. But let's talk about processing time. Now, these are the specs on my computer, which is definitely not the latest in computing. I was able to get an average processing in Starlight Mini of 0.1 frames per second. And you know what that means? It means you're going to need a bigger boat. How much bigger? Well, I checked Reddit, and some users with monster computers, with the latest GPU and lots of VRAM and a fast CPU, they were able to achieve 0.4 frames per second. So I had 0.1 frames per second, they had 0.4 frames per second. So let's say about 4 times faster. This user had a CPU that was 5 times faster than mine, and the GPU was about 2 times faster. Anyway, how might this speed up the render times? So assuming that it's 4 times faster, then a 30-minute video might take 2 days instead of 8 days. Now, if you have a suggestion for the right combination of CPU, GPU, RAM for folks who are looking for a system like this, please do leave a comment. Topaz really is a leader in this, and they're continuing to improve. They're adding more quality options, different price points, more choices, cloud-based, desktop-based. This is great, but will I be using Starlight Mini? Well, the truthful answer is that I will probably continue doing basic denoising and deinterlacing with hybrid. It's not that it's not an impressive software. It's just that at this point, with so much footage that I would have to process, I just simply wouldn't have enough time to process it all on the system I have. Even if I had a much better system, it would still take a lot of time. So perhaps the next thing that Topaz will be working on is how efficient these systems are. And maybe they can cut down that processing time, boost the frames per second rate, and then more and more people will be able to use Starlight Mini. And now, the joke at the end of the video. A man is attending a funeral, and he says to the widow, "Do you mind if I say a word?" She tells him to go ahead. So he says, "Plethora." The widow touches his arm and says, "Thank you. That means a lot."